What excites me for the future is asking the question, what are these synthetic many-body systems good for? I'm Andrei Vrajitoarea. I'm an assistant professor of physics at the New York University, and my research focuses on experimental quantum science. Quantum effects are prevalent in real materials that are relevant for modern technology, such as magnetism or superconductivity. So there is a real-world application to try to understand this phenomena and be able to simulate these real materials. The computational power required to simulate these many interacting particles increases exponentially with the number of constituent particles, which is why this problem becomes intractable with classical machines. And this has motivated my research as well as the research in many teams around the world to develop these synthetic quantum materials where we can explore these many-body phenomena in a highly controlled way using novel detection schemes as well as navigating extreme parameter regimes that would otherwise be hard to do in conventional solid-state materials. One of the recent results that I've worked on was to essentially come up with a new way to control these synthetic quantum materials. The standard approach is to control these quantum objects, these quantum machines, using classical parameters. And we've actually found that we can actually harness the intrinsic quantum nature of our synthetic platform to have genuine quantum control over the dynamics of our many-body system. And one interesting aspect that we found is that we were able to prepare an interesting state of matter where we were in a superposition of being in both a solid as well as a fluid state for photons. And this had important implications into preparing some highly entangled states relevant for sensing. Just behind me, we have our dilution refrigerator that we use to cool down our microwave circuits. And you can see that there's a rack next to it that contains various microwave instruments that allows us to both control each of our qubits as well as to probe each individual qubit. And in the dilution refrigerator, we have individual microwave lines that are carefully thermalized, attenuated, and filtered that will deliver signals to control our individual qubits. And also we have carefully filtered and added microwave components to be able to amplify the very weak signals that are coming out of our devices that are used for mapping the quantum states of our platform. When it comes to building these synthetic quantum materials, the main challenge is not necessarily building the platform out of many quantum systems and having them interact with each other, but it's actually guiding this many-body system to a target entangled state. And this has broad implications to various fields in quantum science, from quantum computing to quantum metrology. But what I'm excited for in the future is thinking of ways in which we can merge, we can come up with a hybrid approach where we can interface either quantum computers with these artificial quantum materials to be able to come up with improved ways to both control and probe these quantum materials, but also hybrid approaches where we can interface classical computers with these synthetic many-body systems where we can harness the complex many-body quantum dynamics to our advantage to be able to solve complex optimization problems as well as coming up with new paradigms for doing machine learning or for doing neuromorphic computing.